For we meet in an hour of change and challenge, in a decade of hope and fear, in an age of both knowledge and ignorance. The greater our knowledge increases, the greater our ignorance unfolds.
A message to the staff is simple. You're not alone, and fight for your rights, and we are fighting along with you. Thank you.
More concerning to me personally is the fact that both Pfizer and AstraZeneca would not allow their products to be sold in Australia unless the Australian government gave them a full indemnity. If they killed anyone or maimed them, they wouldn't be responsible, the government would be. So I find that a very disturbing thing that the government didn't take the view and say, well, if you're confident in your product, you should stand behind it.
But this is the worst, these are the worst crimes against humanity ever, ever committed.
Ja jongens, hallo, dat kan niet. We zitten in de allerergste crisis sinds de Tweede Wereldoorlog.
Dat het vaccin van AstraZeneca veilig is en dat het goed werkt.
Ja, en daarom is het zo belangrijk dat je je echt moet vaccineren. Dus doe het alsjeblieft.
Daarna is hier getoetst. Of het deugt en of het klopt en of het veilig is. Bijwerkingen zijn in beeld gebracht. Ja, weet je, dit is gewoon het allerbeste wat ons kan overkomen deze crisis.
I am 100 years old and the sole surviving prosecutor of the Nuremberg trials.
There cannot be any doubt whatsoever, at least not for me, after having interviewed so many experts from all different fields of science, doctors, virologists, epidemiologists, economists, lawyers, psychologists, psychiatrists. There cannot be any doubt whatsoever that what has been happening here for a year now is, when I first said this, some people kind of rolled their eyes and said, hey, nobody's gonna ever agree with
you. It gives a false sense of security. Did you see? It's completely illogical, it's non-scientific, and it must be abandoned. I fully support the staff of the European Parliament in their positions, the positions of non-discrimination, non-segregation, the freedom to come to the workplace. This is their workplace, along with us, the MEPs. The implementation of proportional and adequate sanitary measures, the vaccine not being compulsory. 100% teleworking offered for vulnerable staff, free and informed consent, as my colleague said, which are prescribed with various international documents from Oviedo Convention, Nuremberg Code, resolutions of Council of Europe. We have Council of Europe right there.
But this is the worst, these are the worst crimes against humanity ever, ever committed.
And you are implying that what we did was responsible for the deaths of individual. I totally resent
that.
And if anybody is lying here, Senator, it is you.
More concerning to me personally is the fact that both Pfizer and AstraZeneca would not allow their products to be sold in Australia unless the Australian government gave them a full indemnity. If they killed anyone or maimed them, they wouldn't be responsible. The government would be.
Because this is on such a magnitude. It's so big that it is very possible that we're going to eventually need to have something like Nuremberg 2.
Law, not war. If you can do that, you save every day billions of dollars, which you can use to deal with the legitimate complaints of old people who need medical care, students who have to pay for their tuition, all the legitimate complaints which could be solved if we didn't spend the money on weapons to kill them instead of helping them. And that is the current system. Now, how are you going to do it? I will end by telling you how to do it and the principles which I have guided me. There are three principles. One, never give up. Two, never give up. Three, I hear you, never give up. Good luck. I wish you the best of luck.